lesson. If fear is not part of your message, technically you're really not preaching the gospel. It's an interesting take there. Rich, can you pop your Bible open to Isaiah 13?
No, I can't.
Isaiah 13. Dick brought up a lot of a couple of verses on the banner. Verse 2, Isaiah 13, 2.
Lift up a banner on a bare mountain, make the voice rise to them, wave the hand that they may enter the gates of nobles.
You know, that verse should have a picture of you. Raise the banner, lift your voice, and shake the finger is what King James says.
How about that?
Amazing. How can people say what we do is not even biblical?
Right.
Yeah. Right. You know, raise the banner. Raise the voice. And shake your hand.
Yes.
That's what we do.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I mean, there should be a photo of us right there. A picture's worth a thousand words.
Amen, brother.
Rich, Brother Dick had mentioned having fear of God. When we first started cranking out these shirts, we didn't put a Bible verse. We just simply put fear God. And it was done for one reason, and that's to provoke Christians so they can confront us and say, that's not New Testament.
Right, right.
And so then we'd show them some of the verses that you brought up. But when we started putting that on shirts, there was no biblical reference, just to hopefully have somebody come out and say something to us. Is it possible to love and fear God?
Yes.
Why do people say it has to be either or? You know, they make God to be schizophrenic. Either you need to fear him or love him. Very simple. I never went to Bible college. You know, I barely photo finished high school. I, you know, graduated high school in 6 years like all of you guys did. Fear and love work together. It's not either or. It's the fear of God that will make me indulge in sin. It's the love of God that makes me serve our God. They don't conflict at all.
Amen.
It's a perfect flow. Right. But oftentimes in Christianity, we've lost the concept of fear. You know, you said, Dick, that, you know, fear means trembling. The definition is very clear. Fear is not a state of awe. Fear is not just reverence. Fear is actually being fearful of God, which is one of the reasons I love our Bible, because our Bible will define words. You can use the Bible to define Bible by using Bible.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
You have an interesting verse that Jesus Christ said. He said, don't fear him which is able to kill your body.
Yeah.
Okay. If somebody's going to put a knife to your throat, are you going to be in a state of reverence? Are you going to be in a state of awe? Or are you going to be in a state of terror?
Yeah.
Most likely terror. But he goes on to say, but rather fear God, who can destroy both body and soul in hell.
Yeah.
So that same terror you had with that guy that's going to slit your throat, you need to have towards God. And you gave good verses as to why, you know, we should despise certain things. You know, it's amazing. We're going to live in heaven where it's nice and pure, and we're supposed to be used to it now.
Yeah.
This is getting used to sin now. Do we despise particular sin now? Do we want to speak out against sin now? Or do we kind of want to just hug it and pretend like it doesn't exist? Fearing God and loving God, okay, they work together. It's not either or. They work together, and they're a perfect pair. Okay, our next speaker is pastor of the church that gave us, allowed us to come here, gave us the key.